using 555 timer. So last class, when come to theory, we discuss what is the internal structure of my A-stable multivibrator. It is how it is working and how to set the duty cycle, everything. One of the example, I'm going to take it here and I'm going to construct it. So, and we are going to realize whether the values are correct or not. So let's move on to that. So what is our aim of the experiment? Just write down the design and implement an A-stable multivibrator circuit using 555 timer for a given frequency and duty cycle. Again, I'm telling, this is the aim of our experiments. We need to design and implement an A-stable multivibrator circuit using 555 timer for a given frequency and duty cycle. They will give a frequency and duty cycle. So you need to design one 555 timer circuit, that to A-stable multivibrator. And A-stable means what? There is no stable state. Continuously 1 and 0, high and low, high and low, it is moving. And capacitor need to charge from 1/3 VCC to the 2/3 VCC. Continuously need to happen. Okay. So then they are not mentioned in this aim. So they are given a general, the given frequency. So they can give any frequency and any duty cycle. For this experiment, for an explanation purpose, I am going to take on one frequency. That frequency value I am going to take on here, it is 1 kilohertz. Okay. You just write down. I am going to take on a given frequency. I will take f is equal to 1 kilohertz. Remember, what is the meaning of 1 kilohertz? So 1 kilohertz, it is a frequency, means I want to find out the time for that. So frequency and time relations are inversely proportional. T is equal to 1 by f. So how to take that? See that. And okay, second thing it is, I'm going to take on my duty cycle here, it is 60%. In this problem, they are telling we need to consider a frequency and duty cycle. Here I'm going to take my frequency as 1 kilohertz and duty cycle has 60%. I'm going to design it. Okay, so now I'll take my frequency first. So first you need to understand the frequency and clock signal. What is the output I'm getting? So this is a high pulse. This is called positive half and this is called negative half. Totally one positive and one negative, what we call it is one cycle. It is one time period. So this is taken as a T. If I'm talking about the frequency means, so frequency, it is a reciprocal of time. One divided by time. Or if you want to T means, if you want to time period is nothing but it is one divided by F. This thing you need to keep in your mind. So now I want to find out what is the total time it is required for that. Out of that, they are telling a duty cycle. What is the meaning of duty cycle? The formula here, it is on time divided by total time into it is 100%. So how much time it is on and how much time, what is the total time into it is 100%. If it is 60% duty cycle means, remember, so maximum time it will come to on time. So minimum time it will go for off time. That is the conditions. So first, what I'll do here, it is, first I'll take the frequency, given frequency, that is f is equal to 1 kilohertz. First, I want to find out what is the time period. Okay. Just I'm going to take on my time value, it is t is equal to 1 divided by f, that is equal to 1 divided by 1 kilo ohm. Just you substitute 1 kilo ohm, sorry, 1 kilohertz. 1 kilohertz means what it will get? 1 by 1, 1 only. The kilo you can consider the numerator. Kilo become here it is 10 power of 3, become it is 10 power of minus 3. Nothing but millisecond. So total time period, it's required, it is 1 millisecond. So what it indicates, we are getting one pulse, output pulse, that is my intention. Along the y-axis, we are going to take on voltages. Along the x-axis, I'm going to take on my time. I want to generate a one pulse. The total time period here, it is 1 millisecond. That pulse, it is having high as well as low. So total time period, I want to generate the 1 millisecond. So total time, it is T. T is equal to, I want to generate 1 millisecond. That is my intention. Out of that, second option you have. Duty cycle they are given. Duty cycle is nothing but T t on time divided by total time into it is 100%, or charging time, or high pulse time. You can consider anyway. So means this time divided by total time, if you do, it will come to the duty cycle. Then I want to find out what is the value of on time and what is the value of off time. Then only easily I can construct my circuit, right? Then how to find out? Let's move on to that. Yeah. So what I am trying to tell, what is the formula for duty cycle? See that duty cycle is nothing but D is equal to on time divided by total time into it is 100%. Okay. Now they are given a duty cycle value and they are given a T value. We already get the T value, 1 millisecond. Then easily I can find out my T on, right? Yes. So now you substitute and tell me what is the value of my T on. So duty cycle, they are given it is a 60%. Directly you can substitute here it is. The value it is 60 is equal to on time. You want to find out. Then T, it is 1 millisecond. 1 into 10 power of minus 3 into it is 100. Just tell me what is the on time. How much you'll get? Calculate, you'll get 0.6 millisecond. Okay. Once you got 0.6 millisecond, then easily you can find out the value of RE and RB, right? So what is the charging time equation we studied in come to a stable multivibrator? What is the on time equation? T on or TC. Yes, TD is equal to, or T off time is nothing but, so 0.693 RB into C. So now what you have to do, if I'm going to use, if I want to know T off time here, but how to get my T off time, that is very important thing. But we don't know off time, but you know the on time as well as total time, right? Then easily can find out the off time, right? How? T is nothing but on time, or it is called charging time. On time plus off time. Or you can take it charging time, TC plus TD. Now you know this value, T is equal to how much? 1 millisecond. On time, you already calculated. 0.6 millisecond, and easily can find out the value of off time, right? What is the value we'll get T off time? Yeah, 0.4 millisecond. That's all. You'll get the 0.4 millisecond of it is off time. Easily you can calculate. Then you know the 0.4 millisecond off time. Then you assume my capacitor value of it is 0.1 microfarad. Then you consider C, assume that C is equal to 0.1 microfarad, then easily you can find out RB value. Once you find out RB value, then again you substitute RB, C and on time, easily you can calculate my RA value. So this is a process you can do. So that is what I'm doing here. It is carefully observe that. So I'm going to take my duty cycle, 60%. The formula here it is D is equal to T on divided by T into 100. D value I'm going to take in a 60 here. On time, T I'm going to substitute it is 1 millisecond. So it get it from the frequency into it is 100. Now I want to find out on time. So what I'm doing, just 1 millisecond I'm going to take it on the left side. 60 into 1 millisecond divided by 100 I'm doing. Okay, so if I'm going to do this thing here, it is the 0 and 0 get cancelled. Next 1 millisecond and 10 you have. So then you can simplify this one. 6 divided by 10 means I'll get 0.6 I'll keep the millisecond as it is. So total time on is I'll get the 0.6 millisecond. Once you got on time as 0.6 millisecond, then easily you can find out off t minus t on, that is 1 minus 0.6 millisecond. I'll get the value, it is 0.4 millisecond. This is what we are discussing. So in this way, you need to solve the problem. So again, I'm see that off time is equal to, already told the formula. Off time is equal to 0.693 RB into C. Now, my intention it is, I want to find out RB. So RB is equal to T off divided by 0.693 into C. Just I'm substituting here. And next, I'm going to assume that C is equal to 0.1 microfarad. This is very, very important. Directly I'm going to take on. So it is 0.1 microfarad, or micro means 10 power of minus 6. That's why I'm going to write in here. So 10 power of minus 6 F. So I'm going to assume that my C value, it is 0.1 microfarad. Just I'm going to substitute and I'm going to simplify. How? See that 0.693 C is equal to 0.1 microfarad and 0.4 10 power of minus 3. I'll tell what is an easy method. Leave these powers. You do this process only. First, you multiply 0.693 into 0.1. If you multiply 0.1, it is 0.0693, right? Then you do the subtraction, division, only 0.4 divided by 0.0693. And tell me what is the value you are getting. 0.4 divided by 0.0693. 5.7, easily you will get. Next, see that it is 10 power of minus 3. It is 10 power of minus 6. You take it to the numerator. So now it has become 10 power of plus 6. Okay, 10 power of plus 6 into 10 power of minus 3. So easily you can do the addition of these two. 6 minus of 3, I'll get plus 3. So that is a kilo ohm. So 5.7 kilo ohm, that is your RB value. Okay, so once you find out RB value, then use a formula for T on and you just find out the value of RA and consider C value is 0.1 microfarad. Just find out that value and tell me the answer. So just I'll write the formula. T on is nothing but same 0.693 RA. Yes, good. RA plus RB into C. Now you simplify. Consider C value is 0.1 microfarad. RB value is 5.7K. And 0.693 into RA. RA value easily can find out. Okay. On time. Just hope you return this one. Next you can find out the on time here. Just use the formula, on time is equal to 0.693 RA plus RB into C. So I want RA plus RB, just I'm going to take an RA plus RB now. Next, T on. So just I'm going to take it, RA plus RB here, 0.693 and C, I'm going to send it to here. Means here, 0.693 into C, on time divided by 0.693 into C. Next. Here, I want only RA. That's why RA is equal to the RB plus RB. I'm going to send it on the right side. So that is this one. Minus RB I'll get. Next, assume C is equal to 0.1 microfarad. Same value I'm going to assuming. Then usually you can find out RA value. RA value here it is 0.1st on time. Already find out 0.6 milliseconds. We already find out, just substitute here. Divided by 0.693 into C value 0.1 into 10 power of minus 6. Same process only you do here. Again, 0.693 into 0.1. It becomes 0.0693. 0.6 divided by 0.0693. Just find out what is the value you will get. 0.6 divided by 0.0693. I want this answer, this part answer. Just calculate how much, ma? No, I want 0.6 divided by 0.0693. What is the answer? -4.8. 8.65 kilo ohm, right? Because 10 power of minus 3, here it is 10 power of minus 6, you go to numerator 10 power of plus 6. Don't take this part. You do 0.6 divided by 0.0693 and you will get 8.6 something. So it will go to numerator, it is kilo ohm. 8.65 minus of 5.7k. You do the process. So resultant, how much you will get? 2.95. Okay, you take 2. How much you will get? You just note down. 2.95 kilo ohm. This is your RA value. So everybody got 2.95 only. Let's move on to the construction of the circuit. Once you got these values, first you need to understand what is the IC of 555 timer and what are the terminals you have. Just write down, this is the IC 555 timer. Here pin number 1, it is a ground, and pin number 8, it is a 8 pin IC only. 1 it is a ground, pin number 8 it is a VCC, and pin number 2 it is a trigger, 3 it is a output, and 7 it is a discharge, 6 it is a threshold, and 5 it is a control, and 4 it is a reset. The circuit diagram already explained and come to on a theory, so how to do the connection. So here it is, what I am going to do, 8 it is a VCC, right? Just I am going to connect my pin number 8 to VCC. Next, reset pin. The reset pin also we are going to connect it to VCC. Next, we are going to connect my discharge pin between RA and RB. In the circuit theory I explained, between RA and RB we need to connect the discharge pin. For the capacitor we need to connect the trigger pulse, as well as I want to connect my threshold. These two just you need to short and you need to connect it to the capacitor. So what is your task? Just write down this IC. This is actually a block diagram. And second thing, pin number 1, it is ground. 3, it is we are taken the output. And 5, it is usually we are going to looking for control field. It is a default. Remember, the pin number 5, always it is connected to 0.01 microfarad. And here it is 6 and 2. And we decided we need to find out these values only. Your task, you need to find out these values only. So we already calculated these values. Just take RA. RA value, how much we calculated for 60% duty cycle? Previously we calculated, right? 2.95 kilo ohm. Just you mentioned in the main circuit. 2.95 kilo ohm. Next, RB value. What is the RB value you have? How much we calculate RB value? First, initially we calculated, right? How much? Just mention 5.7 kilo ohm. Next, C value. What is the C value you have? Yeah, just take 0.1 microfarad. That's all. 0.1 microfarad. Just mention these things, then easily you can construct the circuit. And 555 timer, we can give the VCC of plus 5 volts. So we can give the plus 5 volts. Otherwise, you have an option also in multi-SIM, directly you can connect it to VCC. That is also we can give it to that. This is about the A-stable multivibrator. So along with this one, we'll take some tables also. We'll see that. Yeah, this circuit construction over. We already understand the theory concept. If you take an A-stable multivibrator, my capacitor continuously charging from 1/3 VCC to the 2/3 VCC, 1/3 VCC to the 2/3 VCC. Continuously it will be charged. During the charging time, output heat is high. with the discharging time output it is low, next charging time it is high, next it is a low. That is a waveform what I am getting. Easily can see that charging time it will come to gradually increases from 1/3 of VCC to the 2/3 of VCC, and it will come to a discharge. Again it will charge, and again it will be discharge, again it will be charge, next it is discharge. This process it is continuous in nature. Okay, now during the charging time usually can see that my output it is high. So during the charging time my output it is very high, during the discharging time output it is less, zero. Next it is high, low, high, low. This is my output waveform. So I want to generate this charging and discharging time and this waveform. These two waveforms need to generate. That is our main intention. Okay. So and I already taken some voltage here. It is plus 5 volts. So if it is plus 5 volts means what is the charging voltage you'll get? Just calculate here. You consider VCC value 5 volts and tell me what is the highest voltage I need to get. What is the maximum value in this case? It's a theoretical waveform. So 5 into 2, 10 divided by 3. How much per 3 point? Yeah, 3 volts. Okay, 3.3 volts I'm going to take. So VCC by 3, 5 divided by 3. How much? 1.6. Okay. So these are the theoretical voltages. We'll see what is the voltage it is coming in practically. Usually, if I'm going to use multi-sim, almost you'll get the exact values. But if really we are going to construct it using discrete components when come to a lab, so definitely these values will be varies. Okay. But now we're looking for multi-sim, we'll get the almost the same values only. Yeah. So next it is, this is the output waveform 0 to VCC. VCC means theoretically I want to get it is a 5 volts. You just write down this waveform. So theoretical values and I'm going to get the practical. If I'm going to theoretical means theory until now what I am discussing that values just I'm list out here. And practically what is the values you are getting, that thing you need to list out here. But in the multi-sim, my RE and RB values will not be varies because we'll get the exact resistance values. But practically, if I go based on the BB-RAW, you know, right? Resistor finding. So theoretical tables and practical tables. So I'll just remove the values of practical. So once come to output, we'll write this. So write down duty cycle, theoretically we find out 60%, on time, we already calculated it is a 0.6 millisecond, off time 0.4 millisecond, if you add 0.6 plus 0.4, I'll get total time it is 1 millisecond. Next, if time it is 1 millisecond means you take the reciprocal, the frequency I'm getting 1 kilohertz, and RE and RB values we calculated, how much RE value I'm going to take? I think you're telling something right, 2.0. Okay, I'll take 2.95 kilo ohm and RB value 5.7K and 2/3 of VCC. You only calculated until it is 3.3 volts, correct? 3.3 only, right? So VCC by 3 volts, it is 1.66 volts. These are the theoretical values. And practical, you can take it that and we'll see. By seeing the waveform, I want to decide. But when come to multi-sim, it's almost same values only. We'll decide later. And duty cycle, we can't change. It is designed for 60% only. And we'll tell on time, off time, total time, frequency, everything. Over this one, these tables. So this is theory. Next, we're looking for multi-sim simulation. How to do that? Just open the multi-sim. Let's move on to that. You have a file, just go to file. If you want, you can write down the steps. Go to file. You have a new design. Suppose if you have a previous as it is, what we discussed when come to Xilinx plus close all, previous everything should close it. Go to File, New, Design. So just I'll take one new design. If previous files is there, first close and you can take. After that, it's very simple. I want to construct the circuit. What is my circuit? This is my circuit. And I already told that the values are RA and RB and C values. First, I want to select the high C. So how to select? This is a 555 timer. So in order to select any component of the circuit, you have an option that is here. It is place. Just check it out. You have a place. Just click on this place. You have a one option that is components. Again, I'm telling select place. Under that, you have a component. Select this one. And here I want 555 timer. And you have some options. You can see that database. Here it is master database. You need to select. And here it is group. Just give selected all groups. Just select all group. Under that, for 555 timer, you need to search mixed virtual. So different options. You have a 555 timer virtual, analog switch virtual, you have frequency divider, you have, but it's a monostable virtual is there. So PLL virtual is there, but I want 555 timer, right? Just select my 555 timer virtual. And once you select, just give OK. Once you give OK, see along with the cursor, you'll get the high C. Right? You can place anywhere, your wish. So if you scroll, it easily we can zoom. And zoom in, zoom out, easily you can do that. Somewhere you place, your wish. And once you place, you can see that again the window, it will be plop off. So because you can get the all the components easily will get it out. So okay, first you selected a 555 timer. Next, I want to select the remaining components. So what are the remaining components require? I want the resistors. So I want the resistor. So what I'll do, in order to get the resistor, remember, I'll go to select group. Here only you have some basic. You have an option for basic. If you want to get the resistor, capacitor, anything, you can get it from this. So just click on the basic. Under basic, you have so many components. You can see that. So you have a resistor. First, you select the resistor. And here also, you can select the resistance value directly. So my suggestion, you just select the resistor and give OK. Later, I'm going to change the value. I'll give OK. Place somewhere. Later I'm going to adjust. Again, resistor. I want the two resistors. Give OK. Place somewhere. Just click. Two resistors over. Next, I want one capacitor. In order to get this, you have an option of capacitor. Just click here. Just give OK. That's all. Whatever the components require, just select and give OK. One capacitor is required. I'm going to take not only one. One more capacitor also is there here. It is 0.01 microfarad. That one also I'm getting here. It is. So that's why I'm going to take again OK. Means I'll get one more capacitor also. So two resistors, so two capacitors over. Then anything it's required? No. But we have a VCC and ground. I want to select my VCC and ground also. So for that, so we can use a plus 5 volts power supply and I can connect. But I have an option directly of VCC and ground. I'm going to take on that option. So how to take? You have an option. You need to change here it is. So when it is source, select the source. Okay. Under source, you have a power sources. Again, I'm telling source, under that power source, you have a two option. One, it is VCC. Just select the VCC, give OK. Somewhere you can connect. And next, you have a ground. Give OK. somewhere you can connect your wish. Okay, that's all. After collecting all the components, you can close this. And if you want to get some other components, if you're missing this, you can go to again place and you just give the components and can select wherever is there. Just change my group values, whatever the thing it's require. So again, I'm telling, for the getting of first high C, you need to give select all groups and you need to select mixed virtual and you need to select the 555 timer, give OK. Next, for getting the resistors, go to basic, select the resistor two times and give OK. So next it is capacitor, give OK. Next, looking for it is sources, under that power sources, ground you select, OK, and VCC you select and give OK. After that, you just close it. First, I want to take 555 timer. They are not given any pins here. They are mentioned RST, stand for reset, discharge, threshold, trigger pulse, CON means nothing but control, ground, everything it is there. First, I want to give a name for this. So what is the experiment we are doing? It is in a 555 timer name. I'll give take an ACE table. So just double click here. You have an option label. The labeling you can do any name. So here you have a A1. I don't want A1. I'll give a name of that one. Usually you can give. So I'll give the name. It is ACE table. My wish. You can give any name. You can give. And values will not get anything. Directly you'll get here it is label and give OK. You can see that the name it will change. This is ACE table multivibrator. I'm going to design it. If you're not given also it will work. But it is an indication. So which experiment we are going to do. Next. See the circuit and you can construct. I want to connect 8. It's a VCC. This is connected to VCC, right? So VCC pin I need to connect. So just I'll go. VCC is there. Directly you can connect it to VCC. And here it is 5 volts is there. Directly you just click here. In the same line, you have a dotted line. Just connect it here. That's all. You can see that. Just connect one line here to here. One line you can connect. Similarly, you adjust this. Suppose if somewhere you place it my ground or somewhere it is there, just you just move that. Just click and move. Entire box it will be selected. Easily you can move. For example, if you are placing here means just drag and drop to in the same line. Once you done this, just take the one line and connect it to here. So first you need to connect the VCC and ground to high C. Next, I want the resistor values and capacitor values. But here it is some values is there. I don't want these values. I want both are 5.7K, 1000 picofarad is there. I want to fix the value. Theoretically, we calculated some values. So that values I need to give. First, I want to adjust this resistors of RA and RB and C. How to do this? Just click on this resistor. Complete thing. So suppose if you're clicking R1 means it is wrong. If you click here also it is wrong. You need to click somewhere. Complete box need to be selected. Right click. You have an option of 90 degree clockwise. Just rotate this one. And similarly, this one also just click right click. 90 degree clockwise. Similarly, C1 also. Right click. 90 degree clockwise. CT also, just 90 degree clockwise you do. You just adjust in the one line, your wish. Just you drag and drop somewhere. Okay, I'm going to take it this line. So this is, I'm going to adjusting. Somewhere I'll get the discharge also, right? Yeah, I'm going to adjusting this. And I'm going to take on capacitor. So just give some space. Okay, just you arrange your wish anywhere you can connect. Next, you can do the namings. I want to take the resistor values, right? So I told that it is a RA resistor. So you calculate RA, right? So I want to give that resistance value. Just see, just double click here. And what is the resistor name you are given? RA. Just go to label and you can labeling this. The resistance value it is RA. And resistance value I need to give, right? So what is RA value we calculated? RA value. Second time we calculated, right? How much per 2 point? 2.9 or so. Yeah, 2.6. I think some value you are getting. Yeah, 2.95. You can take this value. Just you type there. 2.95 kilo ohm. So just click on here. It is nearer values also. It will come. It is a 5 kilo ohm. 2.95 ohm. It will come. 3 mega ohm. Okay, 2.95. Okay, I'll give 2.95 kilo ohm. Next, tolerance anything don't give. Just give okay. See that RA value 2.95 kilo ohm I'm setting. Similarly, just double click and change. I'll go to label. I'll give RB. What is RB value you need to give? 5 point. Okay, I'll give 5 point. So here already is there. If you want, you can click here. So nearer value it will show. 5.7 k it is there. It is a 5.62 is there. 6 k is there. 7.6 is there. So I have a 5.7. That's why I have a 5.7 k. It is a value you have. You can select. Just select and you can give. Otherwise, you want 5.7 only means you can take 5.7. You okay. RA, RB high connected. Next, what is C1 value? Means first capacitor. According to the circuit, this value. Yes, just select that. How? Just double click. So I'll take C1 only, not an issue value. So 0. microfarad you want. Just you change some microfarad range. Any microfarad you select. So 0.1 or 0.01. Yeah, 0.1. Just give 0.1. Again, I'm telling, just somewhere you have a microfarad, you just select this and you just alter 0.1 microfarad. Okay, just give okay. Next, C2 value you have, means second IC connected to control. What is the value I'm taken? 0.01 microfarad. Just double click. Again, same thing. 0.01. Yeah, almost this one only. So double one I'm removing. 0.01 microfarad. Just give okay. That's all. 0.1 microfarad, 0.01 microfarad I'm going to take. Next, do the connection. How? Just you connect from this point to take your own line and you can connect it to here. Just if you click means automatically it will be connect. Between RA and RB, just take one line, it will be connect. And RB to capacitor, it will be connect. And yeah, from capacitor to you connect the ground. From here to you can connect. Sorry. From here to you can connect one line. This is also you can connect to the ground, your wish. And pin number 5, this connection I'm doing. Pin number 5, it is control point connected to the 0.01 microfarad ground connection. Just I'm connecting here to here. By seeing your circuit, you can do. Now, this is very important. Reset. Reset is nothing but pin number 4, right? So, reset also, it is connected to VCC, right? Then I'm going to connect this reset pin also to here. And between RA and RB, we need to connect it one pin. That is, according to this, 7 it is connected. 7 means it is discharge. I want to connect the discharge between RA and RB. So just do that. You have a discharge. Just connect. And threshold and trigger, these two you need to connect to the capacitor. Just I'm going to use one line here. It is connected to here. And this thing you can connect it to here. Otherwise you can short here also. Threshold and trigger, you just short and you can connect it to my capacitor. Between RA and RB, you need to connect it to discharge. That's all. This is the input connection. Next, I want to see my output. In order to see my output, so I want to connect one device that is CRO or oscilloscope, right? So you have options here. You can see that you have a multimeter here. Here you have a function generator. You have a, next it is watt meter you have, and you have an oscilloscope. Just click on this oscilloscope. It is used to see the output. That's all. Just take it somewhere. Keep anywhere. So this is a oscilloscope. By using this, easily we can visible the waveform. Okay. So here you have a two channel. This is channel one and this is a channel two. So plus you need to connect it to positive terminals and negative we connect it to the ground. So what I'll do, I want to, so channel one I'm going to connect it. Means channel A I need to connect it to my output. So that's why just I'm going to connect my output line to channel A. Directly I can connect it here. Next, the ground, negative terminal, it is connected to the ground. You can connect the one ground terminal and this part you can take here only you can connect, but just I'm going to connect it here. Just do this connection, ground. Means I want to see the output. Next, I want to see the output of output terminal, means in order to get the waveform. See, this is my intention here. It is, I want to see this waveform, 0 to VCC change. It is coming at the pin number 3. And this thing, capacitor charging and discharging, I'm telling it is 1/3 of VCC, 2/3 of VCC. So whether it is coming or not, that is also I want to see. In order to see, just I want to connect my channel B to capacitor. You can see, just I'm going to use one line. Where is my capacitor? Don't connect. You have a two capacitor right now. This capacitor and this capacitor. Just I'm going to connect the first capacitor. Now to see the output across the capacitor, charging and discharging. And negative terminal, as it is, you just connect it to the ground. So this terminal only I'm going to connect. Just double click means automatically it will be connected. So that's all. The connection is over. This is a small circuit diagram of your A-stable multivibrator. Option here it is, this just run and you have a CRO, right? Just double click on this oscilloscope. You can see some waveform it is coming. So you want to see clearly that waveform. What do you need to do? Just I'm changing time scale here it is. Time scale it is there in milliseconds. Just I'll change to microsecond range. Just click on this scale. Just reduce millisecond to microsecond. So I'll just change. See, I'm going to reducing. Easily you can see the waveform. So usually I'll get 500 microsecond. So easily we can see the waveform, continuous waveform. Just I'm going to enlarge. If you want, you can enlarge and you can see the waveforms. See that continuously charging and discharging, charging, discharging. It is coming and red color what it is coming here it is. This is the output voltages. Okay, now suppose I don't want this colors or background, I want to change, I want in white color. So just reverse this. You can see background it is white color and you'll get the waveform. Okay, so this is a waveform output it's coming. So I want to analyze whether it is correct or not. That is very important thing. We calculate some theoretical values. Next, I want to find out the practical values, whether it is correct or not. For that case, just I want to stop the waveform and I want to analyze. So just I'm waiting for the good condition. 1 minute. That's very fast. Yeah, so I'm going to stop somewhere. You can stop anywhere your wish. So continuously you're getting the waveform. Now I want to analyze. So what is the output voltage maximum I need to get? It's a 5 volts, right? So theoretical, just I want to fill this table. So maximum voltage it is 5 volts I want to get. So whether it is 5 volts, how to analyze, that is very important thing. So just see here. Usually this is actually, it is a display of your oscilloscope. This is called y-axis, we are going to take on voltages, x-axis, we are going to take on the time. So usually you have a two channels in the oscilloscope. This is a A and this is B. So A I'm looking for, this is a red color, what it is coming, it is working for the channel one, and charging and discharging, what it is coming here, it is, this is for the second channel. So along the y-axis, I'm going to take on. So you can see that this is a channel A settings. This is a channel B settings. So what it indicates, scale 5 volts per division means you can see that 1-1 boxes. So voltage we are going to take on along the y-axis only means what it indicates, this complete voltage it is 5 volts and this is a 5 volts, this is 5 volts. One complete division, they are telling it's a 5 volts according to this. So for example, if I'm going to change this one, you can see that if I will change 2 volts. So 2 volts means this waveform also it will be changes. Along the y-axis it is changing. You can see that 1 volts means completely it will be changing. So just I'm putting it's a 5 volts. So easily I can see that my output waveform completely it is coming in the one box. Means 1 into 5 means 5 volts only, right? So highest voltage what I'm getting 5 volts. So theoretically also 5 volts. And practically also it is 5 volts. So completely my theoretical and practical values, I am getting high voltages only. Next, so this is a charging. During charging time it is high. During the discharging time it is low. Okay. Now I want to find out this charging time and discharging time. We are going to, okay, the voltages we already calculated. According to theory, the theoretical values we already calculated. We need to give the justification whether it is correct or not. And we calculated RE and RB same values only. We are given the same values here. Just I'm going to copy paste my RE and RB values. I'm not going to change anything. If you want, you can change and you can check it out. I want to find out 2/3 of VCC value and VCC by 3. 2/3 of VCC it is 3.33. So according to the waveform, what is the value I want to check? Just you have one markers. Just take it this. Okay. See that it is working for high and low voltages. So you can see this bubble. It is a high voltages. We can see the channel A, it is a 5 volts, it is there. Just I'm going to take it in the downwards. We can see that 0 volts. 0 and high voltage, it is working. Next, this will change. Yeah, so I'm looking for this voltages. If you click here, it will go for this waveform. What is the voltages? And here it is, if I'm going to click here, it will go for the this waveform. So if you want, I can just zoom and I'll check it out. So I want to get the minimum voltage. It is 1/3 of VCC. If I want to check it out, you can just drag this one and check it out. So what is the value you're getting? Because I'm looking for this a 2, channel B I'm going to use here and check the value. It is coming the lower voltage. The lower voltage it is 1.671. So what is the theoretical value we calculated? You can see that 1.667. So just practical value just note down 1.667 volts. Next, 2/3 of VCC maximum value. Just drag this one. So maximum voltage. So you can see that 3.327. 3.327. This is what we are getting. 3.327 volts. It's a practical value. So almost the same thing only. 3.3 and 1.6 voltage only it is coming. Next, I want to find out on time and off time. That is very, very important. So how to find out on time and off time? So just see, this is the voltages. Just I'll take it somewhere. I already told that along the y-axis we are going to take on the voltages, along the x-axis we are going to take on time. So now in this case, each one division and time scale for the channel A and the channel B, it is same thing only. Only one time scale, you can see that time scale, 500 microsecond. Here also I'll show that if I'm going to change my time second, it's microsecond, millisecond, this waveform will be varies. That's why sometime if you give a 1 millisecond, 5 milliseconds, you'll not get the waveform. Be careful, and that time you just reduce my time scale. 2 millisecond or 500 microsecond, easily you'll get the waveform. Now, I want to find out what is the on time and what is the off time. So, here it is complete division, it is 1. Each subdivision is there. So, you can see that this is a 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, and next it is 1. 1.2, 1.4, 1.6, 1.8, 2. Similarly, 2.2, 2. Anywhere you can start. It is each division, subdivision, it is called 0.2, 0.2, 0.2 seconds. Whatever the second it you have. So how to find out on time and off time? See, I'm going to take a complete waveform of this one, this pulse and this pulse. One positive and one negative. So from this point, I'm going to counting. See, completely it is one box. How to count? From starting from this point, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, 1. Next it is 1 point, approximately you'll get the 1.2, but somewhere it is there. Okay, I'll take 1.2 completely. If you take 1.2, just note down, here it is 1 point, on time it is 1.2 into, and I want to take the time. What is the time value you have? That is very important from the waveform. Just take it. Time you have a 500 microseconds. Just you need to note down this one also. 1.2 into 500 micro. Just take the symbol of micro. I'll take micro symbol. So 500 micro. So 1.2 into 500 microseconds. So just tell me what is the answer you'll get if I'm going to multiply 1.2 into 500 microseconds. What is the answer? Micro you leave, 1.2 into 500, how much? How much pa? Total? 600 microsecond you will get. 600 microsecond you just convert to milli. Control V. So I'll get microsecond. It is nothing but equal to, it is 0.6 milli. Millisecond only you are getting, right? So theoretical and practical values are both are same almost. And if you take similarly, if you 1.2 is not there, okay, according to that 1.1, and you can calculate little bit, it will be varies. Okay, for this cases, I think you'll not get exactly it is 1.2. Okay, I'll take 1.1. If you take 1.1 and you just tell me what is the answer. I'll take 1.1 millisecond. And tell me the answer. How many microseconds you'll get? Just count from here. Yes. So 1.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, and this one I'm going to consider 1.1. Almost it is there, we nearer to 1.2, but I'll, for explanation purpose, I taken 1.1. So now I'll get the 0.9. So just I'm going to enter and I'm going to take the time. How much pa? 0.45 milliseconds. And now you tell me what is the answer for T, total time, sum of these two. Yeah. We'll get 1 millisecond only, need to satisfy that condition. And what is the frequency? One, you just take the reciprocal of that. I'll get definitely 1 kilohertz. That's all. So when come to, if you conducted really, when come to discrete components, definitely the frequency, time, everything should be varies. But because of multi-sim, we'll get almost the same waveform. Okay. This is a realization of your A-stable multi-vibrator.